Hi everyone, I'm Mansi and welcome to The Foodie. Today, I'm going to show you how to make mawa cake. But I thought, why not add some seasonal flavor to it? So I'm going to show you how to make a strawberry mawa cake. Now this is going to be a double delight because firstly, it will be eggless. And secondly, we are going to make this in a cooker.
Okay, so here we have a small pan. And first what I'm going to do, here I have about a cup of fresh strawberries. To add it to this, and I have 3 tablespoons of sugar. Now I'm just going to let it cook till the sugar melts and the strawberry becomes soft. So in about 3-4 minutes, as you can see, this becomes lovely, and at this point we are going to put the flame off and we'll just keep this aside and let it cool, and let's head to making our cake batter. Here I have 100 grams of butter, and here I have 3/4 cup powdered sugar, and I'm going to add that as well. And now using a beater, so we are going to beat this until it becomes nice and soft. So now our butter and sugar is combined well. We'll leave this and we'll move ahead to our dry ingredients. So before actually we move to the dry ingredients, let's just prep up our cooker. Now this is a regular big cooker. I'm adding a cup of salt. And what you do is you will need a stand because you want to put your baking tray or dabba on a stand. So I have a stand here. Now in the cooker, just remove the gasket. Okay, you don't need this. And you also don't need the whistle. You don't need these 2 things. Put this on the gas and I put the flame on low, and we are going to let it heat for 10 minutes, and in the meanwhile we'll get our batter ready. Now what I'm going to do is put a channi, hold a channi. Here I have 1.5 cup of maida, all purpose flour, which I'm adding to this. I have 1 teaspoon baking powder and 1/4 teaspoon baking soda, and I'm going to nicely sift this. So now we gently mix. Try to mix in one direction. Use a cut and fold method. You cut, you fold. This mixture, I'm going to add 1/4 cup dahi, and to that I'm going to add 3/4 cup milk. You can add the milk slowly, little by little, mixing it gently. And after we've added the curd and the milk and mixed it well, we are now going to add mawa. Now this is ready-made 1 cup of mawa. I have grated it. Our batter is now fully ready. Now mawa cake is incomplete without a flavor of cardamom. So here I have some elaichi powder. There's no specific measurement. I've put a teaspoon and a little more. It's really how much you like. So now what we do is, here I have a dabba, okay? Take any dabba, any baking tin, and I'm going to put some butter. Okay, after I just kind of melt it, using my hands, I'm just going to spread the butter. Now, tap it. First you spread it. Okay. Toothpick, I'm just going to swirl it around. So even from the inside, when you cut the cake, it'll look really nice. So now it's 10 minutes also, and our cooker is also heated. Quickly take our dabba. Okay. And we place it on the stand. close it very quickly again. Now we are going to let this bake or steam for about 30 to 45 minutes. So now it's 45 minutes. Let's open the lid of the cooker. Smells very nice. Now what I'm going to do is just to quickly check whether the cake is fully done. I'm going to insert a toothpick a couple of times. And as you can see, it's come out clean, which means our cake is nice and it's ready. Move a knife from the sides. And if the cake and the dabba is cool enough, you will not have to worry. It's just going to come out on its own. So here I have a plate. The plate, put the plate on the dabba. And just tap a little. And I'm hoping it will come out, and it has. So we're just going to now flip it. So as we saw, it was so easy to make this strawberry mawa cake, and it smells yum. I can eat this for breakfast, lunch or dinner. I loved it. I'm sure you will like it too. So do give it a try and let me know. Bye.